Dear brothers and sisters, many of us believe that the Lord is infinitely kind, merciful, and compassionate. We tell ourselves that when God sees us at the gate of heaven, He will feel sorry for us and let us in. We tell ourselves that He does not want us to suffer. He only wants us to enjoy eternal life with Him. And so, because of this, some of us would like to believe that most people who have died are in heaven. Only very few of, or even none, are suffering eternal damnation in hell. I heard somebody say, "I do believe in hell, but I do not believe that anybody is there." It was his way of saying that God's mercy is without limit, so much so that at the end of time, everybody will be saved, accepted into God's everlasting happiness. So relax, God is kinder and more compassionate than we have imagined Him to be. Dear brothers and sisters, there is a lot of truth in what we have just heard about our compassionate God. However, the problem with such a view of God has crafted God into what we would like Him to be for our sake and convenience. We have painted an ideal God of compassion, meting out no punishment, but has ignored the other side of God, which is His justice. The values of compassion and justice are different and should not be confused. When God judges each and every one of us, He will be a God of infinite compassion and also infinite justice. This means that while God would willingly forgive our sins, He too, in justice, would have to take into account the good and bad we have done in this life. Dear brothers and sisters, the bottom line of today's gospel is that Jesus is challenging us to try our best to enter by the narrow door to eternal life. If we don't take His words seriously, He may tell us, "Go away, I do not know where you come from," and close the door on us. Do you think God's compassion and justice will let this happen to us? In other words, do you think Jesus would take His own words on the gospel seriously? Whether this will happen to us or not depends a lot on how we have lived, are living, and will live our Catholic Christian faith in our daily life. Joseph Isaac Schooling, the winning Olympic gold medalist in swimming, has made every Singaporean proud. I myself also proud. He has made great history for Singapore as the first person to win a gold medal at the Olympics. Anyone who knows Schooling's story knows that it is not just talent, but also plenty of compassion, plenty of passion, practice, perseverance, personal sacrifice, and parental influence. Before the euphoria of making history in the pool on Saturday of August 13, the Schoolings had to first endure 7 years of toil on the road to the top of the Olympic podium. It began with the difficult decision of sending their only child halfway across the world in 2009 to the United States in pursuit of the training environment that could mold him into the world's leader he is today. Joseph's calling just for him then was the one who pleaded to go. His parents were the ones hesitant to take the leap of faith. To help Joseph fulfill his dream, they sent him to Florida. Husband and wife took turns shuttling between Singapore and Florida to take care of their young son, each staying months at a time. It meant the family of three was separated more than they were together, spending an average of just 3 weeks together a year. It has been tough because we are not getting any younger, said the 60-year-old mom. Dear brothers and sisters, the way of Joseph's calling and his parents is the way through the narrow gate. It is similar to the way we are supposed to take as Catholics. We try perhaps many times, but so seldom we try our best. And that is precisely what God expects, that we search and struggle for Him with the effort of our whole life, with great patience and perseverance, with all our heart, soul, and strength, trying our best to enter God's kingdom through the narrow gate. Let us take our faith more seriously and not take our relationship with God for granted. For to take our faith and our Lord for granted is to risk finding our Lord closing the door to heaven on us and telling us, "Go away from me. I do not know where you come from." So let us try our best to enter through the narrow gate, the gate that leads us to salvation. Amen.